then I can get things started. Let me go ahead and make sure that it's muted over on my laptop where I'm monitoring it. There's one announcement. There's two announcements, and there's the third announcement. All right, let me sort up my displays, apply, minimize that, maximize this, and away we go. And I still haven't done jack shit with the N7HQ. So, who knows? That may not be happening. Just because I'm forgetful and I'm not in the habit of actually checking it. So, we'll probably. But fortunately, it. The lowest we'll ever be is 50% galactic readiness. So. We'll see. And yes, for those who aren't, who may or may not be aware, but there is a, but our Mass Effect Legendary Edition has been announced, which will be all three of the original Mass Effect games, and all of their DLC, and you know, every weapon pack put into one coherent package. I'm kind of looking forward to it. And it'll be updated graphics. Hopefully they'll be able to fix a few bugs, especially bugs involving the Mako. That's a lot of shaking. Now we talk to Arya.
I've located the source that's powering the Cerberus force fields.
Yes, I see. Shepard, take a look at this. The general is siphoning power from one of my main reactors deep in the bowels of Omega's mines.
Unfortunately, access is cut off by the force fields themselves.
Not completely. There's an open route through that dark area, then up.
The processing plant for one of the mines. It's been powered down. No force fields blocking it.
We infiltrate there, find our way through the mine, then take that elevator to the reactor's back door.
Good eyes, Shepard. Let's go.
Not without me.
Arya, my patrol caught her in the perimeter.
Please, you didn't catch me. We're allies now. Didn't Arya tell you?
Nyrene was expected, Bray. Return to your station.
The Talons are ready, but if I'm sending my people into the breach, I want to make sure those force fields come down for good. So, like it or not, you're stuck with me.
It's almost as if you don't trust me.
It's exactly as if I don't trust you.
And don't trust
We're
each other.
To war together. I'll make sure we can rely on each other.
Exactly. Trust
Great,
me instead.
Commander. Glad one of you isn't on a power trip.
Go wait by the med bay, Nyrene. We'll join you shortly. Shepard, I have last-minute orders to dole out. I'll meet you there, too. I can almost taste it, Shepard.
Well, aside from the thousands of troops standing between him and us.
Details. We don't have time to waste. Is there something you want to talk about?
What happens when we bring the force fields down?
The people revolt, chaos ensues, and we lead the Talons and my forces on a wanton path right through the General's command center in Afterlife.
A bloodbath.
It's true. When the force fields come down, all hell breaks loose. But as far as I'm concerned, all the blood's on Petrovsky's hands.
That's a little bit of a stretch, but okay.
You think Nyrene's over whatever happened between you?
It was a long time ago. But Nyrene's the type that doesn't forget. I run roughshod over most people, and if the tracks I leave aren't deadly, they're at least permanent. As different as we are, I don't wish her ill. So long as she doesn't get in my way.
Huh. Wouldn't have called that one.
Is your hatred for the General getting the best of you?
I'd say it's bringing out the best in me. The man has turned Omega into a prison and a launch pad for Cerberus campaigns. You should hate him too. I, for one, can't wait to finally get my hands on him.
Oh, yikes. That's big yikes.
More questions.
All right, when you're ready, I'll meet you and Nyrene at the exit by the medbay.
Scouts are ready to go.
Shepard, got a second? I know time is short, but I was hoping we could talk. Alone.
Sure.
Arya will be joining us soon. Now may be our only chance.
I'm not trying to undermine Arya. I know she has to be ruthless. Let her have revenge. I'm not doing this for me, and I'm not doing it for Arya or what we once had.
It's for the people of Omega. I get it.
Someone has to be their voice in all this. Incredibly powerful forces are about to do battle, with them caught in the middle. I just hope, as we bring down those force fields and go to war, that you can keep the people in mind.
You're a veteran. Why are you so disturbed by these adjutants?
I know fighting Reapers is old hat to you, Commander. But these... what they do to people? They could still be out there. And if they return, I don't want to even think about what would happen to Omega's people. The image of that drives me and haunts me.
What's your impression of Petrovsky?
An adversary worthy of respect, and not just because he's shrewd. When I was starting to organize the Talons, he offered amnesty to anyone who set down their weapon. A few of my people surrendered, and he made good on his word.
So he has a code.
And, as near as I can tell, it doesn't exactly match the elusive man's.
Huh. Interesting.
Are your people ready for the fight?
You needn't worry about the Talons, Shepard. They were thieves and scoundrels once, but they serve with integrity now. We're fighting for a better world. I have to wonder if the same can be said for our sorry friend. I suppose we'll know soon enough.
How did you get mixed up with Arya?
I was happy in the Turian military, but when my biotic ability started to manifest, my superiors saw fit to reallocate me. They practically locked me away. I couldn't use my skills to benefit my people, so I quit. I floated around the galaxy, looking for a new purpose.
And you found your way here?
More like I lost my way here. But then there was this beautiful, fierce creature who didn't let anyone define her. I'll admit, I was mesmerized. I wanted a little bit of that to rub off on me.
How close were you two?
The draw was undeniable. Her strengths mirrored my insecurities. Maybe deep down it was the same for her. But trying to be with her turned into trying to be her. Nyrene Kandros was vanishing.
You seem like your own person to me.
For all the drama between us, I'm grateful to Arya. She helped me remember who I am. It took a lot to break away from her, but I regret nothing.
So the thing is, with there's not a lot of Turian biotics in the first place, and so as a result, the Turian military doesn't really know what to do with them, so they just kind of... So they kind of allocate them to basically, you know, to, if you will, rearguard units, I guess. Support units. They don't really do much with them because Turian biotics are very rare. So it just kind of messes with the whole. So it kind of messes with their carefully laid strategies and tactics and all that happy crap. So apparently, as far as the Turian military goes, the easiest way to deal with them is to not deal with them, if you will.
What do you know about the Cerberus force fields?
The technology comes from beyond the Omega-4 relay. Flesh disintegrates upon contact. The power required must be enormous. I fear that disrupting it could destabilize other systems on the station. I hope we'll proceed with care and certainty.
So, now in this mission, at the end, there is a Paragon interrupt that'll crop up only if your character is an engineer. It won't crop up for anyone else. And so, part of me does wish I was playing engineer at this moment, but I will get to the. But I might do a fresh run where I'm playing as an engineer, because that I think would be kind of fun.
I appreciate it, Nyree. We're heading out soon.
I'll be ready.
Commander.
All right, let's get going. Yep, I might switch you to the suppressor, although the Typhoon does have a certain... Kind of weird that this... Okay, so actually the other ones still show up, you just can't select anything for them. Alright. Guess the two upper selection points just kind of blended in with her jacket, if you can call that a jacket.
We're arriving at one of the ESO processing plants. It's been powered down, so we'll have to pry open the door.
I'll get it.
Access to the mine should be on the far side.
And the reactor is beyond that?
According to the schematics, I ran Omega and Irene. I didn't work the mines myself.
No, you had indentured servants for that. Spirits.
Oh boy.
Relax. They're all Cerberus.
They've been ripped to shreds.
I don't like this.
Alright, let's sort out ammo powers. I also don't like the fact that it's quiet, there's no music, and it's really dark. And there's... So, honestly, it's just things that just put me a little bit on edge. And designers knew what they were doing when they made this level.
More dead.
It's a bloodbath. I've got a bad feeling. We shouldn't be...
Quiet. What's that sound?
An adjutant.
Oh no. The general must have locked this place down to keep it inside.
I really don't like the noise. Did I go the wrong way? I did. Oh my god.
Elevator to the mines is through that door.
It's deactivated.
Then we need to power this place up. There should be a master circuit breaker somewhere.
These pipes power the door. We should follow them.
Don't like the continued growling.
Thank you. Maybe the adjutant doesn't like its odds.
Don't kid yourself. I've seen one of those things take down a squad of soldiers.
Well, aren't you just a ray of sunshine there, Nyrene? Really digging all this positivity that you're giving us.
There's the power control.
When this is over, there'll be a lot of repairs to make.
I hope you'll focus on the civilian areas first.
You are relentless.
That's one thing we have in common.
Problem. Big problem.
Wake up.
All right, Reeve.
I hate those things.
Yeah, so Reeve is especially handy because it does inflict a defense debuff. And in truth, it is a very potent debuff. So Reeve is a very valuable power, even though if it doesn't do a whole lot of direct damage. And unfortunately, the big sacky things on their heads are in fact a weak point.
Shepard, look along. Hi. More adjutants.
What the heck is this one? Me out of that. How many of them are there? Die.
I think we got them all.
Let's try the elevator again. Stay alert.
Well,
all right, into the elevator.
Elevator works.
Clear the general sealed that area to keep the adjutants in.
Along with some unlucky soldiers.
Yes. The creatures killed them, but didn't turn them into more adjutants. Can't shake it. Something's off.
You're just spooked.
There's a rhythm to this place, Arya. To Cerberus. If you'd stuck it out here, maybe you'd feel it too.
Whatever's in our way, we'll deal with it.
Damn it. They shouldn't be straining like that.
Cerberus must be working them hard.
Access to the reactor is somewhere on the upper level.
Let's find a way up there.
Whoa. Kaboom. Yeah, you are taking casualties. As a matter of fact, you're the last casualty. You've been voted off the island.
We can use that maintenance elevator across the way.
That's not what I meant to do. Okay. But there. Random heavy melee. Whoop.
That goes under the conveyor belt.
Bastards are running this place too hot. It'll burn out in a moment.
Stay focused.
You know what? Blow it up. A lot of shaking down here. No sense in reactivating it. Thing of powers is dead as it gets. I'm heading up, relax. All that just to get right back here. And hey, the elevator's down here for our convenience.
They know our target. Expect heavy reinforcements. Just stay focused and find the access point to the reactor.
Are you? No, I think checkpoint 247 is permanently indisposed. I needed to go this way. Or, yeah, it was this way and out here.
elevator to the reactor is across the way.
Whoa.
Careful. This place is falling apart.
Clearly.
Strange. We're not being attacked anymore.
Yep, be ready for anything.
Big-ass drill.
Why are you grinning, Aria?
We're almost there. When the force fields come down, this war finally begins.
For some of us, it started months ago.
That wasn't war, babe. That was just warm up. There's the reactor, straight ahead.
Big son of a bitch. And this feels like it's going to be a problem. Yeah. It's a problem.
I commend you. Your plan of attack was impeccable.
Looks like we were expected.
More like lured.
I knew the reactor would be the hard target. I gave you no choice but this route.
It's too bad you're on the elusive man's side, Petrovsky.
I'm on humanity's side. You're the ones trying to start a war for the glory of Aria. But now it's over.
This isn't over until your next of kin can't identify you.
I love your bravado, but have the sense to know when you're beaten. You've been neutralized, and I can leave you there to rot. You might as well give up.
Never.
Aria, what are you thinking?
I'm not going out like this. Aria, don't!
The heck? Biotic powers for the win?
What the hell is she trying to do?
Goes with the biotic field, I guess technically she's not touching it. It's going to be a pretty strictly short-range fight here. The heck is it? Fortunately, Nyrene is actually a fantastic option to have in this fight. Because Overload works wonders on Max. Kaboom. You know what? Heck.
Weapons engaged. Shut down imminent.
Nyrene, you got that side covered? weapon I don't even have. And this next bit is on. And this next little section is on a little bit of a timer.
How did you know you could do that?
I didn't.
So it is to your advantage to not dawdle. They can fight each other for a little bit. Uh-oh. How'd I manage that? This is a problem. Give me a second here, guys. Okay, there we go. Okay, so there's like a tiny little bit right at the corner. Alright.
Shepard, there's no let up. The mechs just keep coming.
Stay alive over there.
Yeah, give me a second here. Okay, so I'll unfuck my stuff as soon as I'm done here.
You can't do this, Commander.
Because I managed to click outside of the... outside of the thing.
Shut it down and thousands of people perish.
You hearing this, Arya?
Yes, and I don't care. Shut it down. Shepard, don't. Try rerouting power away from the force fields.
I'm not taking this interrupt.
Hold tight down there.
Rerouting the power to maintain.
Because they're not going to die. Spoiler alert. Alan, if you were an engineer, Alan, if you were an engineer, you'd have a Paragon interrupt and you'd skip all of this, because you're an engineer. But you can wait it out, and they do a pretty good job of making you sweat. But you can get there.
Despite your best efforts to kill me, your soft heart almost cost me everything.
Quiet, Arya. It worked. Shepard saved us without sacrificing innocent lives. I applaud him.
I suppose. Whatever. You fought bravely against those mechs in there, Nyrene. Very impressive.
But?
Why can't you bring that same grit when adjutants attack?
It's pathetic. You... tense up at the mere mention of those abominations.
Leia, she just saved you.
I'm trying to help her, Shepard. Call it tough love. The war's starting. I don't mean to miss it.
She's never been big on thank yous. reports. All force fields down. Civilians taking to the streets in droves. Cerberus pulling back.
That won't last.
The people don't have the training to go up against Cerberus front lines. They'll be wiped out.
Civilian casualties can't be avoided. You'll have to accept this.
Say what you will, Arya. I won't allow senseless deaths.
Do what you can to protect them.
Of course, Commander.
Arya, right here.
Report.
My team is scouting the maintenance tunnels. We've encountered Cerberus forces escorting engineers. They're moving gear. Look to be setting explosives to the station's central support columns.
Bray, engage. Delay them as long as you can. We're coming.
Got it. Roll out, people.
If they detonate the main column, they'll cut off the way to Afterlife. The Talon offensive will be stopped cold.
So we split up?
Yes. Nyrene, lead the frontal assault. Shepard and I will meet you in the markets after we've taken care of those bombs.
Of course. But don't count on me building your memorials if you get yourselves killed.
I like it when you're feisty. The only route to the central column is through the tunnels.
Shut down.
I know there's more of you. Is that it? All right.
Reinforcements.
Oh, did Ari just straight up shoot through that? Yeah, it looks like she did. Things go splody, and enough with all the shaking. Throws off my aim. I don't appreciate it.
Let's go.
Know what else is down here? Arya's couch. Don't fuck with her couch is the moral of the story here. And give me a second. I need to get my, I need to get my streaming software back up on my other screen here. All right, here we are. Hopefully I can avoid that happening again. Oh, doors this way. Derp. Derp, derp. You know what? Flash. Flash again. Well, the thing worth noting is that Cerberus Guardians move a lot faster when you've stripped their shield out of their hands.
Shepard, we need to get to the central column before Cerberus sets off those bombs.
Yes, we do. I believe there's you can occasionally encounter a little bit of a bug here where. And I do it most of the time.
We're hitting less resistance. I think they're sending forces your way.
They're messing with the support columns. We have to stop.
Nuke it.
Bombs just went live. The console is locked. We'll have to manually disable them. Take care of the bomb, Shepard. I'll handle Cerberus.
Three left.
You know what? Give them something else to think about for a little bit.
Two more.
Kaboom. Yeah, you kind of got to stay still and not do anything else. Like, not even move in place. Fortunately, Arya seems to be doing a pretty good job of keeping Cerberus busy. Oh, there's one over there. You got him.
This way, Shepard.
We're clear.
Good. Nyrene, things are under control here. What's your situation?
We're advancing to the Gozu district.
Move forward. Keep that flank covered.
Yes, boss.
In from all sectors. Save those you can and head for the rendezvous point. We'll meet you there.
We'll do what we can. Nyrene out.
So how exactly do we get to Afterlife from here?
I'm thinking the straightforward approach for a change.
Well, that was violent. Oh, this is where I've encountered that bug. Okay. But I think I do have a way to fix it. Yep, here's the bug. And here's what it does to you. However, I think firing off a couple of powers will usually do it.
Cerberus.
How do you know? Could be the town. Never mind.
Whoa. That's a problem. Uh-oh. It's a lot of shooting.
There are adjutants here. Track their progress and seal the rooms behind us.
Yes, Arya.
And it just got uncomfortably quiet.
Looks like they bit off more than they could chew.
We should get a move on.
Yeah.
With the civilian population contained, we should be ready to initiate the next phase of the project on schedule. Before host conversion, we should begin the process of fusing the control implants to the subject's nervous systems. With the current success ratio, we project being able to surpass demand by 300%. The first generation adjutants have been transferred from the containment area and are being outfitted with the implants. The previous batches have been processed and moved to the storage area. Now control when and where the adjutants convert their victims. Initial testing on various species provides ample proof the virus can adapt flawlessly, regardless of the host used.
Yeah, and we already heard the third entry.
Those idiots were experimenting on adjutants.
That explains the ones we saw earlier.
And so they've got ones that they can control. Cheery thought.
The doors only open one at a time.
Makes sense, considering what they had locked up in here.
Door's unlocked. Let's get out of here. That doorway leads to the Gozu district.
Over there! Look out!
Fucking mech. Fuck out of here. Got ya. Alright, normally I think there'd be something, either credits or something similar, a pickup in there of some flavor. I'm really not going to worry about it. I think firing off a power is...
I liked it better when Morden Solis was here shooting up looters.
Morden is dead.
Pity. He was a very practical kind of Solarian.
Yeah, that... There'd be a weapon mod in that bit. I didn't unfuck my ammo entirely. But now I have. That's a crash shuttle.
Take out the turret.
They did not stand a chance. Because sniper rifle. Doing a quick check-in on people. There's a weapon bench if you need it. It would be so easy. Apparently she's going radio silent, as she just said.
Where's Nyrene?
Scouting ahead. We've got our hands full holding this area.
She's going on to Afterlife.
That's a problem. Oh boy. Except those rounds would actually be working, and we already know that. Our bullets aren't special. Well, apparently she's pissed.
Petrovsky dies now.
What the hell? Not the I'm glitching in the cutscene. glitch in the cutscene. What are you doing?
What now, Petrovsky?
Divide and conquer, Commander. Kandros killed the adjutants we hadn't finished experimenting on. These are fully under our control. The prototypes for our future army.
Hold the perimeter!
That's a problem. Gotta move. And we're finally done with this godforsaken station.
Cease and desist all aggression. It's over. Commander Shepard, I surrender myself into your custody.
That is the most pathetic thing I've ever heard.
Shepard, I'm unarmed, and I can give the Alliance intel on the elusive man.
You'll say anything to save your skin.
I'll let you escape, Omega. I deserve mercy.
Is this true, Arya?
Yes. Cerberus had successfully taken the station and he let me go. Do you feel that, Oleg? That's death. Only inches away. Remember this feeling. I'm letting you live. For my partner and for the war against your master. You better cooperate. Take him, Shepard. You and your alliance can decide his fate. Just get this filth off my station.
Commander, glad to see you've had a calming effect on Ms. Tolok. I tried talking sense into her one time. I look forward to hearing how you pulled it off.
Don't assume you know where this is going.
What? From what I understand, high-ranking alliance POWs lead fairly comfortable lives. Who knows? You and I may even become friends.
Nah.
That's not happening.
I don't think so.
Bray, get him out of here.
If you took that interrupt, I believe you just shoot him on the spot.
I've been waiting to kill that man for months. Walk around with you for a few hours and I go all soft.
This victory came at a cost, Arya. It's not soft to recognize that.
You sound like someone trying to sell something. I admire your tenacity. And thanks to you, I have Omega back.
So what's your plan?
There's a lot to rebuild. Starting with this command center. It may take some time to remove the general stink from my throne. Wonder if I'll ever really enjoy the pole dancing in here again.
Well, that's your concern? Okay.
The citizens of Omega have been through a lot, Arya. Try to remember that.
How can I forget? There are reminders everywhere I look. And don't worry. I'll honor our arrangement. Troops, ships, and a mountain of Izo. You earned it.
Then I'll be going.
Bray will take you back. I have a station to whip into shape. Citizens of Omega, hear me. I, Arya T'Loak, have given you back your lives. My rule is reignited. My hand is on the controls once more, and I will not let go again. Each of you owes a debt. Gain my favor by rounding up the remaining Cerberus invaders, and we will cast them from our home. Then bury and mourn our dead. My methods haven't always been popular, and I can't promise that will change. But securing this station and everyone inside it is now my primary purpose. No one will imprison us again. We may be bruised. We may be bloodied. But we are Omega.
You always get these crap details, Bray?
Not this time. You got a galaxy to save. Let's get you off this rock.
Hey, it's a perfectly reasonable Batarian. Not many of those around. And I just love how there's a Turian dragging a Cerberus trooper by the leg. Like he does this every other Tuesday. Yeah, I bet there's unread messages. And I know there's nothing to really memorial. So it's the Citadel. And it's also in the Citadel. And on the Citadel. On the Citadel. On the Citadel. And we now have a chess set for our troubles. So doing this real quick, let's head up to the captain's cabin here. Because the chess set is right over here. Certainly an interesting arrangement of pieces. If nothing else. I think, though, that's it for DLC content for the time being. I'm gonna run around and do some scans, because I have a bunch of scans to be doing. Athena Nebula, Minus Wasteland. We got these two to do, and then we go to the Quarians. That one can wait. It's Cradle 25% Valhalla threshold. Trike Abyssal just expanded. So, Tara, let's go to the Valhalla threshold. And we'll just kind of work our way around. And in case I haven't mentioned it, Reaper awareness resets every time you do a mission. There's a thing around here somewhere. And by the way, if this looks familiar, it's because this is where the Migrant Fleet was in Mass Effect 2. Alohi?
I found something.
Yeah, it was Alohi. Found it. Oh, this is only 33%. I don't think it was Israfil. Was it Farless? Fuck berries, I shouldn't have waited. This is gonna be cutting it too close. I'm getting greedy.
Faster than light jump successful.
Fortunately, we're done in there. God. Whew. Oh, Garvug. It's very clearly. I don't remember where the fuel drop is though. Because we heard about this from a... from someone on the Citadel. Alright, so here's where the fuel drop is. It's like right here. Actually, I can grab it. And have plenty of time to escape. Haha. Suck it, Reapers. And there's only one thing left now. I don't remember where the fuel drop is in here. I know there is one. But I also don't think I can just scan randomly.
I found something.
Yep, I cannot scan randomly. And there's the fuel drop. And it's a mere 95 units of fuel. That's... nothing. Alright, let's go ahead and explore the Shrike Abyssal, because there's more stuff there. So we know there's only a fuel drop left here, and I'm really not interested in that, but we're going to head over here to Kaizel. Then we'll hit Thal. Alright, so that's the fuel drop. Heshtok. Narskal. Parask. Parash. Lyriat. Yeah, it's Heshtok. You can make your own you can make your own Heshtok in 2 steps. Take hell, then add Vorcha. That's a hell of a way to describe it. Fortunately, do not have a single recognized government. Have a recognized single government that would allow them membership in any galactic league. Alliances between bloodlines are tenuous at best, and the Vorcha's short, violent lives ensure there are few lasting institutions. Reaper invasion of Heshtok encountered little formal military resistance, but the harvesting process is slow. Destroying neighboring cities fails to intimidate Vorcha, who become submissive only if they are physically dominated in person. Cutting off their water supplies simply makes them adapt their bodies to get moisture from food. Allied intelligence hypothesizes that basically Reaper forces are not harvesting yet, instead seeking to immobilize Heshtok's population and prevent them from joining the fight for the galaxy at large. So, what do you know? The Vorcha are perfectly adapted to kicking the shit out of Reapers. Because the Reapers can't do much of anything to actually incapacitate the population. Because they don't scare easily. And they can survive on nearly nothing. Go figure. And the Void Devil's fighter wing has a fantastic low codex war asset entry, and it's great. I will certainly be reading that aloud when we see the war asset map again, or the war asset terminal. Let's enter here. This is not foul. I don't think it was that one. Not, no. Sariat, no. I think it was something in the asteroid belt.
I found something.
Yes. This is one of the fake options for the first mission, for the Leviathan DLC. Did I just run over? I did. I did accidentally run over it. Hey, 400 units of fuel. So basically, if you didn't narrow down enough, and you went to each of the locations that could be that. They put a little consolation prize, so it's still worth going out there. Plot relay jump, Crescent Nebula, Sigurd's Cradle, Far Rim, no. In my cluster, I know you don't have anything, so let's go to the Crescent Nebula next. I'm going to be just working my way around. Tessellae. I know for a fact it's Ilium. Met a surprising amount of resistance. They acquired a large defense fleet, high number of fission weapons, and in the brief space battle. Use them on the Reaper fleet's troop transports rather than their near impervious capital ships. As a result, the ground invasion has been slowed to a crawl as the Reapers manufacture more troops. Go Ilium for being clever. But yeah, there's Reapers keeping an eye on things out here. I think Lucarne is the only other destination of note. Tarith, no. Dorai, no. Where the hell was this one? Was it the one way the fuck out here? The furthest. Where is it? Where the hell is it? Oh.
I found something.
Fortunately, Reapers aren't very alert out here, so I can afford to take a few scans. That's 50%. No? Is there something in the asteroid belt? Yeah. God, that's a lot of scans I could afford to do. Because they're still going, the hell's going on over here? It's just some weirdness. What's this? This looks interesting. Oh, chlorine. So it's an Earth-like world that has a bunch of chlorine. Oh my gosh. Yikes. Chlorine is nasty stuff. Chlorine gas was actually used during World War One as a chemical weapon. It does really nasty shit to pretty much anything that lives. Athena Nebula minus Wasteland, we'll get to that one. Nimbus Cluster, we'll get to that one. Krogan DMZ, Anos Basin, Ibn Crest, Aethon Cluster. We can hit that one, but let's hit the Athena Nebula next. Sorry, I like to get all the scanning done all at once, whenever possible. Parnitha, if I remember. There's Thessia. Yes, sorry, homeworld. Lots of systems that I'll probably be needing to break out the console commands in order to
signal confirmed.
Continue this along. Yeah, Pronoia was the one in here, I think. The Nephrain. What is Lucia? Croken Rebellions began at the... Sorry, Lucia. Well, at least they're resisting the invasion. Let's see here, 2.6 AU, orbital period 4.1 Earth years, day length 57.4 Earth hours, atmospheric pressure tolerable. It's only slightly higher than what Earth has. Surface gravity is a little bit higher, but not terrible. Surface temperature 12 Celsius. So that's the average temperature. I believe that would put it slightly warmer than Earth is. I think. If 12 is the average. Sioni, Gallic, Neocal. I think it's Neocal. Nope, not Neocal. Krala. I'm going to have to make a return. So I know where it is.
Reapers eluded.
But I'll have to. There we go. But I'll have to come back to that one when the Reapers aren't on my ass. Almost half my fuel. Nasia, no. Ilmnos? No.
Signal confirmed.
All right, I'll have to come back to this one later. Bye.
Faster than light jump successful.
Am I going to have enough fuel to make this one? Barely. Oh, yeah, I know. I could always go back and...
I found something.
I'll be back for this one, too. Because I'm an idiot. So, if I'd run out of fuel... Don't care, because there's a fuel depot right here. And at least we know where everything's at. That's the good news. We know where it's at, we just haven't collected most of it. Alright, now let's head to the Aethon Cluster. Seal.
Signal confirmed.
Yeah, I think your rune actually has two items for us. Fuck berries.
Reapers eluded.
Wish I hadn't done that in the mass relay. So Leo, Mola, Yantao, Artu. I think this is the only name in that rings a bell.
I found something.
And I was right. Have the Kunu. Turns out the Volus have a dreadnought. Satu Ard. Then we'll hit Nura, and then I will kind of show off how to get into a system advantageously when you're already being hunted by the Reapers. I'm not going to be able to get that one.
Faster than light jump successful.
So I'm getting sloppy because I'm not remembering which planets are important. Gorgon, I don't think so. Omakur. I think Omakur's the one. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's Omakur. I was right. Is that close enough? Yes, it is. So if I recall, the mass relay for this is kind of this way. So you approach, and more or less the angle that you're at, it'll put you on the side so that you're facing directly. Yep. See?
Evasion successful.
Ha ha! Perfect. Horsehead Nebula. I don't think there's anything there. Exodus, Kite's Nest. Gemini Sigma, Hades Gamma, Attican Beta, okay. Let's hit Attican Beta. I don't think there's anything of particular interest in there, but I've been wrong before. Sated, Zatorus, no. Eletania. I think it's Eletania. Yep. Let me just fix that real quick, like, because, oh boy, that's a long haul. And out here, I don't remember Sharing, Saitao, Quana, no, Pharos. It's definitely Pharos. Kind of a flashback a little bit to the to Mass Effect 1. Only gives you about a little over half the fuel you spent to get here, but hey, beats nothing. Rift, Sager's Cradle, Valhalla Threshold, Track of Abyssal. Alright, so I think with this, sorry, my cursor is appearing on the wrong screen, which is why I'm doing all of... God damn it. The hell? That's unusual. I've never actually had the game do that. I don't think there's even a fuel drop in here to grab. Alright. Dealing with Cerberus. Tell you what, let's bring Edie and... Right now, I kind of want to bring James. But let's go ahead and cycle Edie's appearance. Info, power recharge plus 25%. This one is shields plus 25%. That's because she's kind of frail. Yeah, Edie, in case it's not obvious, is kind of your replacement for Morden.
Provided many details.
Sir, I'm picking up chatter from a Cerberus squad engaging the supply depot.
Engaging the scientists?
And if I'm reading it right, sounds like more troops are on the way.
Okay, set us down, then get out of here. I need these scientists alive.
Frosty. Fully automatic weapon, you fire one shot. Come on.
People do to bring this down on their head.
I drops.
Jacob, how bad?
I'll live, I think.
This is Commander Shepard of the Alliance. The enemy is clear for now. Open the door.
Is Jacob there?
It's okay, Bryn.
Oh my god.
I'm all right. The others didn't make it.
What are you doing here?
I'm supposed to be protecting these people from the elusive man and his attack dogs.
Are they gone?
For now, but they'll be back. Sure you're okay?
Yeah, I'll walk it off. Save my life one more time and I'll start owing you.
This one's on the house.
Shepard. This is Dr. Bryn Cole. She's in charge here.
Tell me what's going on. Intel says you're Cerberus.
We're all ex-Cerberus. Scientists, mostly.
Civilians?
Call us refugees. If we hadn't run, we'd be dead.
Why does the elusive man want to kill you?
Our stories are different, but the themes are the same. We were each using information from the collector base to work on the different components of a larger tech. After someone completed their component, they disappeared. No bodies, just gone. As we progressed, we started feeling like we were signing each other's death warrants.
The elusive man doesn't mess around. If he can't control it, he'll destroy it.
The brain trust here has to be a significant loss for him.
You had to know they were going to find you.
It's a pretty smart bunch. We covered our bases.
But the elusive man is one tenacious bastard.
Time to evacuate.
Agreed. Just need to get the AA guns on the roof back online. Cerberus is jamming them somehow. With those guns down, Cerberus will just blow our escape shuttles out of the sky.
Might be the network link.
I'll check and meet you upstairs.
Jacob, you should get that wound looked at.
I'm good. I mean, I will.
Commander, I should see to my people. Join me upstairs when you can.
Jacob did not recognize me. This may be an opportunity to surprise him.
Let's just focus on the mission.
Dr. Brown, I'm so sorry.
Jamie, I didn't want to come here.
Your partner was brave. He wouldn't want you to crumble like this.
He's right.
We're getting out of here alive. I promise.
Thank you. Oh.
Commander Shepard, Dr. Gavin Archer, we met on Project Overlord.
That's one way of putting it.
No kidding.
Yes, well, after you took my brother to Grissom Academy, I tried putting all that behind me. But I suppose you have any news from there. I've heard rumors the Academy is in trouble.
Tempting, but...
I was at Grissom Academy. Cerberus tried abducting the students, but David's okay.
Oh, thank God. Commander... You have no idea what that means.
It's a little late to start worrying about his safety now.
I never stopped. I know you think I'm a monster, and you're right. Not a day goes by where my dreams aren't haunted by what I did to David. All I can do now is hope that one day he forgives me.
What are you doing here?
I strayed too far from the path. This was my only refuge. As a boy, I wanted to be a scientist remembered for doing right by the world, curing a disease or discovering a new element. Not a monster who tortured his own brother.
What did you say to the elusive man?
I told him if his intention was to work with the devil, he only had to look in the mirror. I wanted out of his nightmare.
He just let you go?
If it had been that easy, I wouldn't be hiding here.
A little late to grow a conscience, isn't it?
The galaxy has orders to shoot me on sight.
What happened to Project Overlord?
After your intervention, the elusive man insisted I find another test subject. Someone who shared my brother David's abilities. I couldn't bear the thought of reliving the nightmare, so I destroyed all of my research. Overlord is no more.
Well, at least there's that, but you're... Yeah.
I have to go.
You're a cunt.
And I'm not even going to pretend it was good to see you again.
I understand. But Commander, thank you for saving David. Both times.
So, weapon bench, because you would have encountered a couple of weapon mods, I think, by this point, normally.
And make sure those samples from Project Mia get out on the second shuttle.
I've already dropped one box. My hands were shaking so hard.
We're going to make it.
What's the status of the guns?
Still waiting. I have my best people on it.
How many scientists are here?
43, plus research assistants.
How the hell did you go dark with so many in tow?
When you fear for your life, there's a lot you can do.
Bryn, I can't possibly dismantle the genetic amplification components in time.
I'm sorry, Dr. Boehner. It's important work, but right now you need to tend to your family.
Wait, there are families here? Children?
A dangerous choice.
Agreed.
So these refugees brought everyone with them?
Yes. We have about 17 kids here. Partners, spouses, parents. I promised these people refuge. A new life free from Cerberus. I just never imagined the elusive man would...
That's what evil counts on. That it's hard for good people to imagine. Okay. Everyone left gets out of here alive. This escape will have to be carefully executed.
I'd hoped... We tried so hard to make sure it wouldn't come to this.
What's the news?
Can't tell. Only know I can't fix it from here. I'm going to the roof. Cerberus landed a shuttle there a couple minutes ago. You in?
Jacob, you're injured. I'll fix the guns.
No way. These are my people. I'm going.
Just because you survived one suicide mission doesn't mean you get two.
Fine. But I'm gonna talk you through it from here. Cerberus is probably jamming the satellite link. Radio me when you found the controls and I'll give you the override code.
Will do.
But we're not quite done yet. There's a couple of pickups. I believe right here.
Some kind of poison. Tailored to Turians.
Told you that we should have gone to Sanctuary.
No, you shouldn't. Sorry.
And meet you at the shuttle bay.
I don't want to die.
Go. Just go.
No. I'm okay. Let's just do this.
Chuck, I'm in here.
Isn't there a couple other things of a note? Yeah, there's that. Some shielding. Handy.
Hey, you okay? How've you been?
Give us a minute. This is crazy. I didn't think I'd ever see you again.
I know the feeling. So how'd you become a gun for hire?
Long story. It was an opportunity I couldn't resist for people I came to care about.
You seem good. You look good.
These are great people. Defending their ideals. I like it. I think I found what I'm meant to do.
You still think about what happened to your dad?
Haunts me more like.
Yeah, we could just leave it there.
How long have you known Brit?
We met through a mutual friend in the Mumbai cell. Guess I've known her for a year. We had a lot in common. Then she came to me about her missing colleagues. Asked for my protection, my help finding a place to run to. How could I say no?
Who is she to you?
We're together.
And you run this enclave with her.
You settling down, Jacob?
Yeah, maybe. It's just, if these are our final days, I want to spend them protecting these people. Building a life, whatever's left of it.
What's the story, Jacob? Why are you working at a place like this?
After we got back, well, things look different when you come back from a suicide mission alive. So I quit Cerberus, I quit everything. And sat by the Mediterranean for a while. That's when I lost track of you.
You sat on
the
beach?
What did all that fresh air and meditation teach you?
That what I choose to fight for better mean something to me. That it comes from the heart.
We could sure use you.
It's real tempting, Shepard, but I like where I'm at. I'm important to these people. I want a life. I want a family.
Sure, I get that.
No, Shepard. The Normandy's your real love.
Doesn't mean I don't want to stay to hell with it sometimes.
But you won't. You can't.
Anything on Cerberus I should know about?
The elusive man became obsessed with indoctrination. I know that. You ever wonder how it all went wrong? I mean, was I blind? I remember him being an idealist. How come I couldn't see the evil?
Don't beat yourself up. And if you ever get that crystal ball working, give me a heads up, because I'd love to know how this all plays out.
Right.
And that's it for Jacob.
I'm getting these people out of here.
You bet. Let's get to it.
If Jacob says we're going to be all right, I trust him.
But my daughter, she's just a baby.
A hastily assembled militia is no match for a Cerberus force of any kind.
Elusive man really wants these guys.
And here's where you pick up the Carnifex. I am not going to equip the Carnifex.
Hostiles on sensors.
Just go ahead and deal with that now. Pull! Just swat him out of the air. Nice shooting, James.
Jacob, this should be back online now.
Affirmative, but the guns are still down. You'll need to manually activate them. Head back to the front of the facility.
More hostiles incoming.
Cover. tag.
Those AA guns
manually. There we go, and back up the ladder. And here's the first one. Obviously, it's Edie.
I need you to fix this.
I will make the repairs.
Okay, James, it's on.
Bring it.
God, not again. Fortunately, James seems to have things pretty well covered. I'm just going to spin around this way to help keep my cursor out of the cursor troubles. Now there'd be a weapon mod right down there that you'd want to pick up before doing all this. Or before at least activating the last thing.
Ships out of the sky. Where are we at?
On track. First shuttle is already loaded with everyone under 16.
Commander, when should we leave? What's our best chance for survival?
Jacob, what do you think? Are we ready?
Almost. We could go now. There's no do-overs here.
Agreed. We get one shot.
And we don't want to leave anything behind that could strengthen the elusive man's cause. Your call.
We don't have anything else to pick up, so...
All right. Let's get these shuttles in the air.
Yes, yes, this is the knockoff Hoff.
And launch shuttle one.
Shuttle one is away.
All right. Everyone here head to the shuttle bay and...
Suicide fighter took out one of the guns. Cerberus troops are...
Get those people out of here.
Let's go.
Just go ahead and help warm you guys up. You boys look cold. Let me help you with that.
Roger that. Jacob, bring up the main door.
Got it, Shepard. Will do.
Okay. Let's get these.
All right. Edie.
Jacob, come in. What's your status?
Shepard, the facility's overrun. Cerberus troops are all over the place.
One more shuttle of refugees to go, right?
Affirmative.
We got this. Just need to hold them a little longer.
Did you already deal with them? If so, wow. Time to bug out. We're done here.
Skin of our teeth again, hey Shepard?
Make a habit of that now, don't we?
Nice to see you back in action.
Yeah, feels good.
I was afraid we wouldn't get anyone out alive. But because of you, we got almost everyone. Thank you.
Dr. Cole, I have a request. One you can't afford to turn down. I need your help against the Reavers.
Without a doubt. I'm at your service. And I'm sure you can count on the others as well.
You too, Jacob. I need you.
Of course. But I wouldn't mind staying with these folks.
I get it.
Keep them safe, then. The Alliance needs that crucible.
You got it.
All right. Report to Admiral Hackett for your assignment.
You know, Commander, I've never met anyone like you. Just feel better knowing you're on our side.
Thanks.
Shepard, when this mess is over, drinks are on me. Be safe out there.
Hackett here.
I'm sending you a large team of scientists.
I have the dossier.
They're all Cerberus defectors. Keep them safe.
Will do, and I'll put them straight to work on the Crucible.
Jacob Taylor is with them and is already working to find a place for the families.
He'll be a valuable asset as well. Snagging Dr. Cole from the Elusive Man is a coup. Having her on our side could be a huge win for us.
The sooner we can get the Crucible finished, the better I'll feel.
I'm with you.
Shepard out.
And let's check out the war terminal, because we just got a pretty big jump in everything. So for the alien, we got the Volus Dreadnought Quunu. Quunu. That's harder to say than you think. The Void Devil's Fighter Wing. So basically, they are abnormally focused, especially Vorcha standards. And they are heavily motivated. Got a Vorcha labor team. So that's handy. Liquid assets from the from Ilium, the entire Omega Ezo horde. We have the Omega raiding fleet. So, they've been making good use of themselves, if nothing else. Apparently, they especially hate Cerberus Phantoms. And we're getting as much info out of Petrovsky as we can. Let's see what we have for the Asari. Yep, the Nefrain. It's the only. Alright, so we have the. We have Exogeny Scientists. We have an Interferometric Array. An Element Zero Converter. And Emergency Fuel Pods. For Ex-Cerberus, got some Ex-Cerberus scientists from this last mission, Dr. Bryn Cole from this last mission, because we spared him. We also have Dr. Gavin Archer from this last mission. And, of course, we picked up Jacob Taylor from this last mission. Yeah, I know. Don't really have a need to do the rounds, because right now, I think only Steve would have anything to say, because he's the only one who says anything after an op against Cerberus. But we can finish off stuff here, I think. Yeah, so let's head to the Aethon cluster. Got some stuff to pick up there. most notably here at Satuard. I think the... God, I forgot. Here, fixed. Plus, I think we have everything, though. Or at least we have the important one. And actually, now we have them all. But yeah, a lot of these cases, you get one scan, and you better find something. Or Volus engineering team. That would be handy. 200 units of fuel, I'll take it. Yeah, I think there's one thing here. What the hell? Why is there three here at Aru? Am I just forgetting one? Oh. Jerks up. Okay, so... I was just straight up forgetting one. Volus fabrication units, and now it's only a fuel thing left. And I thought for a second I'd have to do another narrow escape. Let's head here to the Athena Nebula, and we'll pick up the stuff that we got the scans on last time, but weren't able to get, and my... That is troubling. My stream just decided to shit the bed. So I'm now dropping a ton of frames right now. I'm hoping it's not terrible. Because I'm looking at it over in my stream manager so I can... Oh, that's the delay. Wow. So, it ain't good. I think we already have... Tomorrow. So, I always misread that as tomatoes. Hey, tomato! Ha ha! Enter the system. Investigate that. I'm hoping that these dropped frames clear up. Because it's kind of worrying that it's doing that again. So, that's not fun. Yep, I don't need to go to Parnitha. I need to go all the way over here to Ilessa. I think that's how you pronounce that. Tricalon. I can hear a cat of mine squalling in the background. Sorry, engineers. Just do that real quick here. And hey, looks like the brief network fits have subsided. That is nice. Just kind of wish I wouldn't do it in the first place, but, you know, one thing at a time. 400 units of fuel. That almost got me back to full. Palissa. Launch a probe. And a Hesperia period statue. So actually, we've got enough stuff going on. We might do another mission, head back to the Citadel. And call it good. Because now we've picked up most everything we can pick up just by scanning. So let's head over here and then investigate this Asari colony over here in the Nimbus Cluster. Right.
Signal confirmed.
Tritagos. I think it's Tritagos that has something. Wow! Skin of your teeth, indeed. Should have saved that one for later, but I think the other one's like just as big. Intact Reaper weapon. Gotta run.
Reapers eluded.
Surprises, it's only 50%, because I'm like, what's the one I'm missing?
I found something.
Carcosa. God. Library of Asha. And there's nothing else here. There's not even a... Not even a fuel drop. Pania, Ethrone.
Signal confirmed.
Investigate. I think this one's just fuel. Yep.
Faster than light.
So I'm out of here. Fortunately, we have a mission we can go do to reset things back in Pelion. I don't think there's anything here at all. Let's just head here to Lessus. So a very sparsely populated garden world. Interesting. And, wow, average surface temperature of 38 Celsius. This place is warm. Like, really warm. So, obviously, we're bringing Liara. And, let's bring Javik.
Dig up any information on the mission, Lyra?
I did, and I now understand why High Command wanted to hide it. We're headed to an Ardat Yakshi monastery.
Ardat Yakshi? Like Morinth?
Morinth chose to be a killer. These Ardat Yakshi isolated themselves to avoid that. But it doesn't mean they're harmless. Their urge to feed can be powerful. That's why High Command sent in commandos to investigate the monastery's distress signal.
What were the commandos' orders?
If there was a chance the Ardat Yakshi could break loose, the commandos were to purge the monastery.
Purge? You mean destroy?
They would have brought heavy explosives with them, yes.
Morinth was dangerous, but are the Ardat Yakshi this big of a threat?
Morinth was just hitting her stride. Ardat Yakshi who kill leave behind astronomical body counts. It's why they can never be free, and why they're such a great source of shame to the Asari. That's why High Command won't rest until this place is destroyed. They'd never risk a single Ardat Yakshi getting loose.
Don't assume anything. Maybe the Ardat Yakshi sent out the distress call. If the Asari want us to destroy this place, I need to know what happened.
Agreed. Once we give a report to High Command, they'll stop wasting lives here.
The shuttle is warm, recently used.
So there's someone else here.
Elevator disabled. To prevent entry or escape, I wonder.
The hell was that?
That sound. There's more than one out there.
More than one of what? No, I wouldn't want to encounter it in here. Do a full sweep of the area.
I hear something.
Stay sharp. I heard something.
That was my fault, sorry.
More of the screams, we'll check on that in just a bit. Wake up early, breakfast also early. morning meditations for it's a hefty chunk of time. Study from 8 to 10, chores from 10 to 12, lunch from 12 to 12:45, classes all afternoon, another study period for an hour in the evening, supper from 6 to 7, evening meditation from 7 to 8, 2 hours of free time, and then curfew. Strict schedule, busy days. But it could be worse, I suppose.
The Reapers want with Ardat Yakshi. Anything useful?
A floor plan marked with the nav point location of a bomb. It's in some place called the Great Hall.
The commandos decided to purge this place.
Ardat Yakshi or not, evacuating this place would have saved a lot of lives. If there's no survivors, let's get to the Great Hall and set off that bomb.
Remember, if there's anything of interest back this way, maybe not. Big courtyard out there.
Didn't hear you.
Samara.
It has been some time, Shepard. You are a most welcome sight. The corruption here runs deep. I assume you're here on your own, Justicar. Perhaps for something special? You are correct. Two of my daughters live here, and I have come for them. Unfortunately, the Reapers had already infested this place by the time I arrived.
You met me hunting down your other Ardat Yakshi daughter. Are these ones just as dangerous?
Valer and Rila have followed the monastery's rules ever since they arrived. They've shown no inclination toward violence.
And you're here to save them?
They are my responsibility. And it's one that cannot be abandoned, even as our galaxy crumbles.
Let's go together. Maybe your daughters can tell us why the Reapers hit this place.
I suspect they will have much to tell us. It has been centuries since I last saw them. We're out of time. We'll meet again. I will draw these creatures off.
Wait! Let's go.
Isolated fortress. The Ardat Yakshi must have believed they were safe from the war.
If they knew about it at all.
They learned.
Well, I guess they did learn. The hell? Oh boy. So now there's mutated Asari. Two for one.
Done.
Guess the same thing they always do. They harvest it.
As soon as I was able. Shepard, this is Falair, my youngest. She and her sister Rila are Ardat Yakshi. They have
Mother,
been...
they have Rila!
What?
I saw some of those creatures take her into the Great Hall. I've been trying to get there.
What are the Reapers doing here?
Harvesting us. They're turning us into those monsters. Please, you can't let that happen to Rila.
The Asari thought the Ardat Yakshi were to blame for the attack.
This is our home. Most of us are grateful to be here. The monastery is a place Ardat Yakshi can achieve peace.
Valair speaks truthfully, Shepard. I vouch for her words with pride.
Well, certainly is a nice break from the last time we saw her interact with one of her daughters, a.k.a. breaking her neck.
Then we have to find Rila fast. The Great Hall has a bomb in it.
A bomb? What, didn't you come to rescue people?
We'll try, but we can't leave this place standing, Falair.
You sound like the commandos. They didn't stop to help anyone.
Falair?
I'm sorry.
Valair!
Can't say I blame her for being at least a little bit angry.
The Great Hall. She's looking for Rila.
Yeah, that's not really a trick I can do here.
We'll meet you there.
Please be swift.
I guess I'll go find some stairs? Yeah, I know, I'm supposed to go that way, however. I think there's a bit of dialogue over here.
You'd need a crowbar to pry those doors open. This place was beautiful before the Reapers came.
However, there's an argument to be made that it's just a gilded cage. And to extent it's true, however, Ardat Yakshi are a special case, if you will.
Jethro, this is Galay. I've blocked extranet access. We don't need the students panicking about these Reaper rumors. Still, it will not hurt to tally our supplies. Please bring me an inventory before evening prayer. I'll contact Cessia later tonight to inquire what sent the Asari to war. Go in peace.
So, they were aware. But they didn't get anything verified in time. There. Just quickly deal with that. Here's where you find the disciple. In my opinion, it's actually a very handy shotgun. If you're dead set on using a shotgun, or you want access to the shotgun mods, and you're playing a Vanguard, this is, in my opinion, one of the nicer options if you want to be able to still use your powers a bunch. However, I still stand by my statement of that the best shotgun in the game is still the Talon pistol, because it does as much damage and has access to the pistol mods, and is otherwise generally fantastic. Hall or something across the way here too. We'll get down there. So Galay cared for her. I guess students, prisoners, hard to say. Interesting. Whoa, there's a weapon bench in here if you wanted it. Oh, fuck berries. Sorry, the banshee screams startle me a bit pretty much every time they happen. And I do mean every time.
Another dead commando. The Asari should have rid themselves of the other Yokshi.
By rid themselves, you mean kill.
My people would never let such monsters walk among them.
They didn't care for the competition.
Oh. Javik, if you can't take it, don't dish it out. Just saying. That's a problem.
Why did she do that?
Because they've begun to turn her into one of the Reaper's creatures.
I'm sorry.
we set off that bomb?
We need a detonator.
Commandos would have had one. We've got to find it.
Problem, guys.
Later.
All right. The number of banshees you get to deal with goes up with difficulty. By the way. And it goes up drastically. I want to say on insanity, it's like 5 or 6.
Solaire, go! Take the elevator! Rina, what are you doing? It's too late for me. There are hundreds coming. Just go.
Move.
No, Rina. I love you, Rina.
There's no saving her. Come on. Ugh. Not. God, these things creep me out.
Goodbye.
Few can break the Reaper's hold. Rila's will was extraordinary, as was her love for you.
We left her to die.
Rila made her choice, and it has reminded me of what is truly important. Why I swore I'd lay down my life.
What is that?
Valair, the code demands an Ardat Yakshi cannot live outside a monastery that no longer exists.
What are you doing?
I'm sorry, Shepard. By the Justicar's code, there is only one way to save Valair.
Mother, no!
My daughters, you were all...
Nope, not letting this happen.
What are you doing?
Fulfilling the code.
By throwing your life away?
I won't kill my last daughter.
You won't have to.
Valair?
I'll stay here. Home. No matter what's become of it.
Without a proper monastery,
I could have left any time. I don't need a building to honor my own code.
And if the Reapers return, they won't take me alive. I promise. Then, the code permits you to stay, as you are. Once this war is over, and if I am able, I will visit, as a Justicar should.
I'd understand if you wanted to help Falair rebuild a home here.
It must wait now that I can help oppose the Reapers. I'll speak with Falair, then join your forces. If you'll have me, of course.
I'd be honored.
The honor is mine, my friend.
Kind of wish Samara would join the Normandy, but she doesn't.
Everything's taken care of down here. Bring in the shuttle.
Right, Commander. I'll just follow the smoke.
And they forgot to put the radio effect on that voice line.
I read your report, Commander. We had no idea the situation had deteriorated so quickly.
That's why I set off the bomb. There were no Ardat Yakshi left.
May the Ardat Yakshi find rest. What the Reapers did to them was monstrous. I had another team of commandos headed to the monastery who I can now formally transfer to Admiral Hackett's command. They'll serve you loyally, Commander. Farewell.
Now we have some rounds to go do. So on the Asari, we picked up some stuff. We have another Asari commando team. And we picked up Samara. And from earlier, we have Asari research ships. And Asari engineers. Close to actually hitting the end of this little bar here, even without a high readiness rating. What we picked up from for the Crucible, Volus engineering team. The Volus fabrication units. Very handy. So, back. Actually, this is going to take a look. You take a look at the war map. This is pretty much where things are at. Well, good. Good on you, Private. Good on you.
You've got new messages, Commander. The Crucible Project received some new tech from the Asari government.
I'm glad they've decided to help the war effort.
Everybody has to fight now, no matter how pretty you are. I learned that the hard way. Commander?
Alright. Let's take a look at the Private Terminal email. Crucible update from Dr. Cole. Settle meet up from Jacob. Settle meet up from Samara. And Asari squad ready. They'll be riding with the second fleet. And from Bray, some follow up about Omega. Talon's the new security force on the station. Well, at least they're following Nyrene's example. And yeah, Bray, you're probably about the only Batarian out there who doesn't want me dead. So, I'll take what I can get, I suppose.
time recruiting now. Glad you talked Samara down.
I never thought I'd see her flinch from her duty.
I don't know. On one hand, that code's all she's had to live by for, God, centuries. Then the galaxy goes to hell. The old rules don't cut anymore. I mean, we're cutting some corners, right?
A few.
Well, the Alliance can always court-martial us after we save the galaxy. Commander?
Edie, do you have anything to say?
What are you doing, Edie?
Monitoring reports of proton storms and other space weather. With the Reapers attacking the comm buoy systems, critical warnings may be lost.
How bad are these storms?
If we are warned, not bad. If we are not warned, very bad.
Thanks for the info, Edie.
Hello, Shepard.
And moving on, we'll do our rounds. I think I might call it a night. We'll start up next time with making a run to the Citadel, because we've got a bunch of stuff we can do there now.
I've always loved the M35 Mako. It's got heart, you know.
Oh, come on.
And then we'll go see what's going on with the Quarians.
Come on, that thing's made of tissue paper. At least the Mako can take a few hits.
I'd hope so. That thing handles like a drunk rhino. No agility whatsoever.
More like a bull that can climb and climb for days.
It only climbs because of its stupid, vertically aligned mass effect field. Jump or stick. No speed. No lateral movement.
Hey, with a cannon like that, who needs to move?
If you want that, why don't you just stick with the old M29 Grizzly?
Hey, I love that tank.
You would be one to love grizzly bears, Mr. Vega.
What? What's so funny?
Clueless.
You know, next time we're at the Citadel, I think I might hit a nightclub. You should join me.
Fair enough.
The next time you blow up a monastery, let me know you've left the premises, okay? I worry about you.
I don't think we'll be blowing up any more monasteries, so not to worry about that.
I appreciate you checking in on me.
Alright. Vega, what's your rate of the situation?
Hey.
Nothing. Okay. You're a wonderful conversationalist. You know that? Engineering. What does... Javik... ain't here. Oh, he's probably up on the next deck in the lounge with Garrus, if I had to expect.
Kenneth, have you seen the new poker table up in the lounge? It's going to waste.
Well, I was thinking of inviting Tsoni, a trainer, up for a wee game of strip poker.
Right. You're not going to invite that reporter Allers, too?
Nah, she'd bring cameras and record the whole thing.
And if you lose, you don't want the whole galaxy knowing how little you bring to the table.
Stop, girl. My back roll is just fine.
Oh, this is poor Donnelly.
Commander.
Alright, nothing there. Allers, how are you doing? You have a couch over here, you have a... there's a bed right there, you have a chair over here. You don't have to stand right here the entire time, but what do I know?
Huh. Second Star Broadcasting is headhunting me. I liked their Garvik story, but seriously, I'm on the Normandy.
Yep, the only frigate in the entire fleet that has its own PR department. Albeit the department's just one person. But, hey. So here, Liara's in her cabin, yep. And Garrus and Javik are here in the lounge.
Everybody was fighting the Rachni, trying to push them back through the relay. Finally, the Krogan were turned loose and stopped them.
I see.
But, when the Krogan rebelled, we had to deploy the Genophage to stop them. Wasn't the only... rebellion. 1,000 years later, the Geth revolted against the Quarians. That was a whole other war. Then along came the humans. My own people tangled with them for a while, and now, to top it all off, we've got the Reapers. What about you?
The Ouroboros fought the Densorin. The Andoromai conquered the Vandomar, and the Jatil turned against the Jah.
So, I guess nobody really ever gets their act together.
The Sinreal claimed to have found the path to eternal peace.
What happened?
The Dittaker preferred war and wiped them out.
I hope you guys had alcohol.
Agreed.
Samara's the kind of soldier we need in this war. Nothing gets in her way. I just hope I'm not in her way someday. That woman means business.
Oh yeah, you've seen what she does firsthand.
Now it's a mutated Asari. The Reapers are just a giant nightmare factory that never ends.
Yep, and we're not done yet.
I can only imagine what the Reapers are doing to the Drell. Or the Hanar. Or the Vorcha. This could get a lot worse before it gets better.
I don't think they're having much luck against the Vorcha, as our scans have shown.
Maybe later.
Some of the crew seem shocked by the monstrosities we have encountered. They haven't seen what the Reapers could corrupt after 100 years. That was our war. Every battle conjured a new nightmare. This human holds such childish views of war. Your species has much to learn. Commander.
It's a brilliant tactic, when you think about it.
But it's evil.
When has that ever mattered in war?
Yeah, but converting other life forms into Reapers? I can't wrap my head around that.
Makes sense to me. It ensures you never run out of cannon fodder. Eliminates any local resistance. And for every soldier you add, your enemy loses two. The one you converted, and his buddy on the other side who can't pull the trigger on a friend.
Sound like you admire them.
Same way I admire a virus or a thresher maw. They've adapted perfectly to their situation.
But the Reapers want to destroy us.
And I have no intention of letting them. But if you don't respect your enemy's capabilities, you're in for one nasty surprise after another.
Garrus, once again, hits the nail on the head. We've got some stuff here at the Broker Intel Terminal.
Have we heard from Agent Detrace yet?
She has not reported in for over 8 hours, Doctor.
She was stationed on Valchir when the Reapers invaded. I think we can assume what happened. Inform Agent Calamus he's now in charge of reporting Reaper activity past the Loas Relay.
So we have an intact Reaper weapon. So we get either weapon damage plus 5% or ammo capacity. Honestly, I'm going to go with the ammo capacity just because my SMG burns through it like a motherfucker. Volus Intelligence Archives. So, power damage or health bonus. Let's go with power damage. Glaze electronic signature. So, this one, you can get a store discount. This is one of only two in the game. Or power damage. Since the store discount really doesn't matter, power damage. And yeah, if you're going to be buying, on your first run through, if you're going to be buying something like the, one of the Spectre requisitions weapons, you'd want to wait till at least you had one or both of those store bonuses, because those things were expensive. They're like 88,000 creds.
She set off that bomb, Shepard.
You're not upset the monastery was destroyed?
No, not after what I saw. I don't care that they were Ardat Yakshi. To be turned into such creatures,
Nobody deserves that. Hello, Shepard.
All right.
At your service.
And that actually concludes our rounds. So, here we are. So, next time on Mass Effect 3, we head to the Citadel, turn in a bunch of side quest stuff, talk to a few, and as well as hang out with a few current and former squad mates. After that, we head out to see what's going on with the Quarians. As far as streaming schedule, tomorrow is more Mass Effect 3, and I'll be returning to my normal schedule, sort of. So Tuesday, I think, should be able to have, I don't know if we're going to be having Halo 3 ODST per se. Might. I don't know what Gene wants to do on that front, so playing that one a little bit by ear. Next weekend, though, on Friday the 20th and Saturday the 21st, I will not be streaming because I will be out of town. Don't really have a good way to do any kind of makeup streams for that, and for that I do apologize. It's just got some things I gotta go take care of, and I will be away from my desktop during that time frame. And I do not stream from my laptop, just because I don't even have streaming software on. I don't have a streaming client installed on it at all. I just use it mainly because it gives me mainly just to have the stream manager open. But with that, I will be back again tomorrow. I'm looking forward to doing some more Persona 3. Think I'm gonna ease off on the obsessive persona fusing, just because. Honestly, because I know I'm playing on a lower difficulty, so using slightly under leveled personas is the worst thing in the world, and it'll help save money in the long run. So there's that. Anywho. I'm going to hit save, and then exit game, unscrew this up, alright, I will see you guys later, stay safe and have a good night.